6 minutes into the flight. With the oxygen supply dropping and confused by the effects of hypoxia, the pilots are struggling to make sense of the situation. For flight attendants Andreas and Harris, the deployment of the oxygen masks is the first dreadful sign they have that something is seriously wrong. The chief purser takes off her mask to reassure the passengers that all is well. She then tries to contact the flight deck, to no avail. Fifteen minutes after the deployment of the masks, the oxygen runs out and slowly everyone succumbs. At some point, Andreas must have fitted himself and Harris with portable oxygen. Andreas goes forward to investigate. He finds all the passengers and his colleagues unconscious. But they are about to be confronted by a formidable barrier. Following the terrorist attacks of September 11, all cockpits are fitted with specially reinforced doors. The only way in is by entering a security code.
I don't know whether he knew the code or not, but just imagine, in the panic and confusion, well, you can easily forget things you know.
Still in autopilot, Flight 522 is locked into a preset holding pattern over Athens. Two F-16s have been scrambled to intercept the Renegade plane. As the two fighter jets approach, Andreas and Harris finally gain access to the cockpit. How, we may never know. The two fighter pilots watch helplessly on as Andreas takes control of the stricken plane. He disengages the autopilot about 15 minutes before the crash. But then, the first engine cuts out.
He always used to say to me that planes don't fall from the sky. But when the pilots are cool-headed, nobody gets hurt. And even when it's lost its engines, it can land.
But time is running out for Helios 522. With the fuel exhausted, the second engine cuts out.
I sensed something was wrong because I tried to call Andreas on his phone. He didn't answer me. So obviously, I'm his dad. I sensed something was wrong.
I found an incident from 2003 in which a Boeing 737 suffered a complete pressurization system failure. Everything seems to have gone wrong.
The aircraft was flying between Marseille and London Gatwick in May 2003. At 34,000 feet, the plane suddenly lost pressure. This problem was detected in time by the pilots, and the aircraft was safely landed. But it emerged that the loss of pressure was caused by burnt wire. This wire is crucial as it connects the pressure switch in the cockpit with the outflow valve. If this valve is open, the plane depressurizes. Investigators later established that the main wire and the backup run through the same loom. In other words, if one wire fails, they both do.
This is totally contrary to safe design practices. Backup systems should always, always be routed away from primary systems.
Helios employees reported a burning smell on Flight 522 only days before the crash. But it seems that no further investigation was made at the time. As Kim investigates the 2003 incident further, he makes another shocking discovery. Even though the plane had lost pressure, all the instruments in the cockpit still looked normal. There was no indication that the pilots had a problem.
If this happened to the Helios pilots, then this would explain why they missed the warning signs.
Throughout all the pre-flight and takeoff checks, the Helios cockpit would have appeared fine.
On the ground, everything looks normal to the pilots. In the air, when the alarms go off, the flight deck still looks normal. And then hypoxia sets in.
Starved of oxygen, the pilots would have then become increasingly confused about the conflicting messages their instruments were giving them. This could explain why they did not descend in time to a safe altitude to avoid hypoxia. This wiring problem with the 737 was highlighted in a report by the Air Accidents Investigation Branch. The AAIB recommended to Boeing in 2003 that the main and backup wires should be reinforced and separated across all their 737s in service. So far, Boeing has not responded to these safety recommendations. Kim's discovery highlights a potentially fatal design flaw, which could explain the Helios crash. It also raises enormous questions about the safety of all Boeing 737s flying today. Every 5 seconds, a Boeing 737 takes off somewhere around the world. There are over 4,000 in service. Air accidents are rare, but when they do happen, they are devastating.
Είχα ένα γιο, ήταν το χρυσάφι μου.
Είναι ένα κομμάτι που φεύγει από πάνω σου και πονάει.
Πολύ δύσκολο να δεχτείς ότι θα έρθεις στο σπίτι σου και το διπλανό σπίτι θα είναι άδειο.
I just want justice in memory of those we have lost. Nothing else.